1966, September 6th. Two Air Force pilots traveling south through the Smoky Mountains crashed their Cessna 150 into the trees. They survived and walked out. The plane is still there, and we're gonna find it.
Flies out. I'm really scared.
Right here.
Right.
I mean, intersects. It's somewhere right up here on the right. But we're right here.
The pretty holly gaps throw me off.
Yeah, we were oriented wrong with the map.
No, but I mean, here's Swallow Ford Trail. That's Swallow Ford.
One of those two trails I parked in Baldwin, Lake Shore or whatever it was.
Tell me what you're doing.
I'm right assembling my new White River IMA 4-weight, 5-piece backpacking ride. It's an 8'4", got plenty of backbone. And I'm going to catch us trout so we can eat. Trout and eggs, that's what we're having for breakfast, trout and eggs.
We got this on backwards. No, don't roll film.
It's my new backpacking rod.
I'm complete now. I can die and go on to heaven.
Of course, that would be much better if I get a trout on it first.
I've got some even smaller in my dry box.
He's a fast little booger. All right, I'm gonna let him go now.
Find a mouse.
Terry scared off a mouse. So hopefully I'll still have my crackers tomorrow. Everything will be okay. My thorn was Terry and Nick ragging me all the way up here about my driving. I thought I was doing a fabulous job, but no matter what I did, it was wrong. I love them to death, but they were getting on my nerves. Yeah. My rose was lunch today.
Success.
Yeah. That was just a beautiful spot. It brought back memories of backpacking years ago, memories of me and my dad, and it was just fabulous. Beautiful spot.
Well, my thorn, I guess, on this trip was the fact that Barry Payne didn't get to come. But the rose is kind of twofold. Number one, it's that Tim Ramey got to come. Always wanted to go in the woods with Tim, have a big time. And the other half of that is that Scott didn't get to come. But all in all, it's been a beautiful day, and I'm just proud to be here.
My thorn was my new boots aren't broke in enough, and they hurt my feet a little bit. But they're feeling better now after a few Advil. And my rose was that, unlike last year, there was no rain. And that has been awesome. Just enjoy the trail and all.
Well, I guess I would start out with my rose today because it has just been an awesome day. It's been a good hike. I'm just so happy that I had the opportunity to come here. We're camping out in the woods by a creek, by a river, by just out in God's country, and it's just been an awesome day. And my thorn would have to be the simple fact that I didn't get to close this night out talking to my girlfriend Ellen. That would be about the only thorn that I've had today. So it's been a good day.
My thorn was getting rid of too much stuff because I didn't have my aluminum foil I planted to fix my tortillas on. So I had to eat them kind of cold and half burnt. So. And the rose is just absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous weather, beautiful. Couldn't ask for a better day.
Okay. Hello, Cloris. I wish you were here. I guess that my rose would be that I had cell service the whole way. And I guess my thorn is those nasty butterflies chased me all over the trail and they landed on me.
All right, what happened?
Well, I was listening to a bear story and got scared and stepped on an amber, and this is what happened. Fortunately, it didn't go all the way through.
Tim, that happened to me last year too. It happened to me last year too. My boots
really
got burned.
Golly.
Good morning to all.
All right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, just thank you so much for this awesome and beautiful morning you've given us. Father, I just thank you so much for revealing yourself through your creation. I think that's awesome, and I just love being out here. Father, thank you for blessing us so far, keeping safe, and I just pray that as we go off trail today that you'll watch over our stuff back here at camp,
and keep us safe while we're off the trail, and just help us to have a good time. Father, pray that everything we say and do around other people around here will bring honor and glory to you. And again, I just thank you so much for your many blessings. In Christ's name I pray.
He was. You think he was smelling the packs and took a dump?
Yeah. So this looks like a good spot right here.
Now tell us about the consistency again.
If the consistency is what we're looking at here, kind of thin and runny, it means it's got meat in it. If it's similar to a dog's poop, and kind of fibrous, it's got more plant life.
Meat eater. Carnivore.
Yes, the good thing is it's next to this campsite, not next to our campsite.
Feeling good.
From the highest of heights to the depths of the sea, creation's revealing your majesty. From the colors of fall to the fragrance of spring,
so you would point this to the way you need to go, correct?
Airplane to the arrow. That point right towards the airplane, but you can't necessarily do that. At this point, we got a trail.
Right.
So we'll just connect the dots to the point. Which sounds pretty easy down here.
It's Kate.
No problem. We got to go. I can just leave it up. And,
yeah.
I've seen heavenly storehouses.
Ron, what do you think about it so far?
Love it!
Isn't that awesome?
Love it, love it, love it.
Good.
Sound, see the heavens open up.
can't help but celebrate, cause we're not alone. If God is on our side, who can be against us? If God is on our side, we won't be afraid. Though the mountains may fall and the sky will crumble, there ain't nothing will hold us standing our way. Come on down to the riverside to wash it all away.
Mile barrier has been broken.
Behind your troubled mind for an unclouded day. Nothing's gonna separate us from the fire.
And we made it to the ridge. There it is.
I can't help but celebrate, cause we're not alone. God is on our side. You can't be against us. God is on our side. We won't be afraid.
We'll take our stuff along the way.
Though the mountains may fall,
this place right here where Ron has said is considered a clear spot for where we're at.
Back though. Okay.
I mean, I guess the thing to do is go down, hit the creek, see if we can follow it up.
Why didn't we do that to begin with?
That's the one we started up on. We couldn't get up
there. Yeah, but we can't be back on the creek. Get back to the creek.
Different creek. This is the creek we forded.
We need a Chevrolet. We need a whip bang.
I mean, unless we see a way that goes to the...
I got three.
To the south, it looks clear, but that doesn't look very clear.
Hey, look, we're getting real close to 18.3. No, I think he's lying.
What do you think? Which way's the plane? Plane is south.
Due south?
But that don't look good. I'm thinking if we go down a little bit, maybe we can either skirt around it, or we might have to go to the creek and follow the creek up. That's all that I know to do. We know that's bad.
This thing can't be right. 0.9 that way.
That's what I got. So we're within a mile.
Right there.
What?
You're right there next to us.
Golly. See how we can tell.
See how this other string comes in to this one? We can walk a little way and see if we can hit that.
We're at UTM 302. We're close to 18.4.
Close to here?
Yeah.
Plains here.
Yeah.
So we should be coming up on that
fork.
The fork in the river.
Yeah.
Road.
We hadn't already come to it.
Be on the lookout for a fork.
Yeah. A fork in the creek. There's lots of beautiful ramps and it's really a good view along the way. Ready to go up the creek a little bit?
All right, Nick, where are we?
We're at this fork, right there. Means we're at least halfway.
And we're making time.
And we're making good time, even though I don't have a trekking pole.
Trekking pole?
1.5 trekking poles.
So that would be the tally of the life. No glasses, one missed radio, one lost water bottle, one trekking pole.
One bandana.
One bandana. A lot of skin. March, balls. But I tell you what, this is the funnest time I've had in a long time. This is great. I'd recommend it for anybody. So come on.
See you in the morning.
We're at the fork.
We think we've made great progress the last 15 minutes. We think we're probably 15 to 30 minutes from the plane. We're running a little close on time, but hopefully we'll be okay.
Closing in.
We haven't lost any more gear. And lost any more gear in the past 15 minutes.
But,
look above our head though.
Water is becoming a crucial situation.
So what are we thinking?
What does it need to be when we come across?
Tell you what, about 10.
I'll let you look. No, wait a minute. We said one is 4. So 4, 8, 16.
To the creek ends.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, about 20. Creek ends about 20. You want to go in?
going back and forth between 22 and 23.
Is it giving you a distance?
Well, officially, according to the GPS, we got to within 0.45, but we think we're closer.
Do what?
We think we're closer.
I hope it is. The trouble is, that's what it's going to look like.
We're still climbing. We got about 30 minutes left, so we've really tried to pick up the pace.
It's about on 48. 40. Four, eight, sixteen. It says around 19. And then we are so close. Trouble is, you can pan a bit. Trouble is, it's right up that way.
Well, everybody's out of water. We're pushing it on time. We're all over it, but we can't find it. The agony of defeat once again.
Any words?
Too tired to talk.
All right, now we gotta go back down. It is an absolutely gorgeous view up here though. You see the ridge across? That's it.
I can have to say I am one tired puppy right now, but this has been one of those experiments that we will remember. And it looks like we'll have to wait till next year to come back and find the plane. We got so close to it, but you know, so goes it. Still been a good day.
I'm exhausted and dehydrated. I'm glad to see this trail. Home's not far away. Let's roll.
I saw on the video earlier the care that we took in crossing this. Carefully not get wet and not let it go. Okay, we have a new technique this time. It's called just crossing. This is how it works.
Piece of cake.
Mountain rock art.
What?
Mountain rock art.
God did it.
Move your arm. All right, look like you've a little blood on your drawers.
Just a little scratch.
A lot of mud and blood. That's what separates a man from the boys.
And emergency band-aids.
Oh yeah, band-aids on the flanges.
You know, some things in life you really take for granted. Actually, most of the things in life you take for granted. It's so nice to have clean socks and dry feet.
We watered up. Every single container we own got water in it.
I'm exhausted.
me.
Thorns and roses. I guess my thorn for today would be the fact that I lost my glasses somewhere up on the Smoky Mountains. So, you know, if anybody comes across them, you know, I guess, well, I'll never see them anyways, but that'd be about my only thorn other than the fact that we all, you know, truck through, you know, a lot of thorns, but it was a good day. And that would be part of my rose. It was definitely, it was a good day. This is one of the most aggressive day hikes I've ever been on. I've been on plenty. The terrain was really incredible, and I would have to give all the glory to God. Like Nick said earlier today, that we all had opportunities to twist an ankle or do something bad, but we made it down good. So I guess that'd be my rose. It was just a really good day today. And I had some strawberries in my trail mix that were really good too. So that's it. I'm done.
My thorn today was about an hour before we came out. I'd really twisted my knee. I was struggling. I'm going to make it, but it's hurt. It hurt a lot, but I knew we had to get out. But that was a big thorn in my knee, as to say. My rose today, the other thorn was we were so close to the plane. I mean, we were right on top of it. Just could not find it. My rose for the day was right in the middle of the thicket. Terry and I were jokingly, the plane went over and he said something like, somebody would say, who's that down there? And, hey, Daddy, look at that. And Terry said, look there, there's big wuss. And I thought I would just die right there. That was just a funny moment and good stuff.
Thorn today, besides the real thorns, is losing the bottom part of my trekking pole. It's a bummer. And, like Tim said, not finding the plane. Even though we were so close. Rose, I love that trail. The very first part of the trail where we're walking beside the creek is so beautiful. And it's a blessing that we didn't have anybody hurt today.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, I'd have to say that today my thorn was that I lost my favorite blue bandana. It was a bandana that my late German grandfather, Herr Nessler, gave me, and he actually used that bandana to pop Hitler on the butt. They had that kind of relationship, you know, they cut out and played around and stuff when the war was going on. And what was my other thorn? I ran out of gas, I have to admit. 250 pounds, haven't been able to work out much lately. Been my cardio, been sick, had a little diarrhea, and back problems. I don't think the two are related. But anyway, ran out of gas, and also we ran out of water. Somebody had recommended, matter of fact, the person who had been backpacking for Rusty over there, recommended we take the pump, and we didn't. And by the time we got back, we were parched. I couldn't have spit if somebody had held a gun to my head. And my rose was... Does anybody remember what my rose was?
Nobody got hurt.
God took care of us on that, and we had plenty of opportunities to get hurt. And by the way, if Ron would have had the camera, he could have caught me spinning around and falling flat on my face practically, couldn't you? And just being out in this awesome, beautiful mountain. Less than 1%, less than 3% go get out of the pavement or out from behind the windshield, and then way less than that go off track. I don't recommend you do that. It's tough stuff. It's what separates me from the boys. So it was a beautiful day.
My thorn was when I slid down the hill and cut my finger, and that hurt. And then slipped and twisted my knee, and that hurt. And now everything hurts. My rose was getting to take some awesome water creek pictures with my new camera, and I'm anxious to see how those turn out. And it was just beautiful everywhere we went. That's it.
Amen.
wondering what I got on, Sherry.
The best part of waking up. The best part of waking up. Oh. Let me get the camera out of my face.
I can't do the hardcore cold. You're going to have to go with the foo-foo cold.
No, I'm not
doing it with my
And Nick's eating what? Looks recycled.
I go oatmeal.
It was his vomit from yesterday. Camp tip of the day, learned from Ron, who's working the camera. Seal skins. Pan down your shoes there. You can put your seal skins on and still wear your sandals or put your wet boots back on and not have to worry about the water. That's can be an inconvenience, but doing the way he's doing it is a huge convenience and a great tip of the day.
Camping tip of the day. I brought bagels and I saw Ron put his in a Ziploc bag, dip it in some hot water. Hence, you have a toasted bagel. Camping tip number 123, bagel breakfast. Thank you.
Camp tip number two. I remembered yesterday, as I lost my bottle of water, to make sure you got a carabiner attached to everything. That way, you don't lose it. Tip number two, that one's free.
And that's the camp tip of the day, brought to you by Cabela's.
Terry, get your book in your seat down here.
That is one leg. The other leg. Arms. Oh yes.
Other arm?
Other arm. The other arm stayed fairly clean.
You got a...
There's a couple of nasty ones on it.
Yeah. Tim, got a few scratches here and there.
Got a few scratches there. For some reason, it's just my right leg. Oh well.
I mean, calves, them's cows.
Slice them, dice them.
What about that gouge in the back? Look at that. Oh my gosh. Where's that? Somebody get a stitch. I need to go get a stitch putting that in.
Yeah, see how that flies down there pretty good? So get them slide down there. Sealed up that way. That's about where he had. So in fact, they flat together like that.
What's this one do?
Good. See, before you see them all, do you know the wing? It's got a front line on that.
The dots versus the thing.
Let me sink this.
mountain maker, ocean tamer. Glimpses of you burning my eyes. The worship of heaven fills up the skies. And you made it all. Said, let there be. And there was all that we see. The sound of your voice, the works of your hands. You do all things well. You do all things well. You do all things well.
Old pot. Further verifies our deductions and conclusions and assumptions that this all used to be inhabited, logging.
There. What is it?
Bed rail.
More bed frame.
Don't do it.
I don't know how we survive out here. Better than snuff and not half as nasty.
How many sayings does he have?
Was it time for thorns and roses?
Could be, I guess.
You're the man with the camera in your face.
Wow. Kind of caught me off guard. Move on, somebody else.
I can't think of any thorns today. Today was a really good day. I guess my only thorn, if you had to call it one, would be the fact that this is our last day here. And that, you know, breaking up from these guys, it's been a really good 3 days. These are some good guys, some fun times. And I guess my rose, I guess I'll be going home to my rose. She's sitting there waiting. Probably not just waiting, but Ellen, I've missed you this whole time, so we'll see you tomorrow night. And I guess that's it.
You thought?
Ron. My thorn is Rusty's rose.
There we go. I knew that was going to happen. I knew I was putting myself out there for all these guys to give me a hard time, but I really don't care because I love you anyways.
Oh, please, please. Oh,
I love you, Rusty.
Got one yet?
Well, really don't have any thorns today. It's been a gorgeous day until these crumb snatchers came in here at camp. They've quieted down, so I guess that's okay. But good rose today was the waterfall we hiked to. It's just a gorgeous spot. And next week when times are getting rough, and I'm getting all bent out of shape, I'm gonna close my eyes and think of that waterfall and bring me back to this place.
Thorn today. Tim and I didn't have better luck catching fish, especially when I tried to cut my throat with the line as I was casting. But anyway, that's another story. Rose would be the hike to the waterfall. The hike was nice, the waterfall was awesome. It's pretty cool.
Well, this ends another day, April 16th, Saturday. I guess my only thorn of the day is, as someone already mentioned today, is the last day. It was an absolutely beautiful day. Biggest rose of the day was I caught 10 fish, several rainbows, I think one brown, I wasn't sure. And my first brook trout on a fly rod for a total of, I think, 10 fish. We'll say 8 to 10. The smallest of which is about 3 inches and the longest of which is about 8. And it's absolutely spectacular, though. Beautiful. Temple.
My thorn today was about falling and busting my hiney over getting wood. I had so much I couldn't see where I was walking. Twisted my knee a little bit again. And my rose, I guess I'll see her tomorrow night. Ellen, I really love her. No, my rose was the waterfall was gorgeous, and I got some good pictures. And I'm anxious to see them enlarged on my wall. So.
Toe warmer as well.
And I recommend the brown sugar and cinnamon. It tastes delicious. A little toe jam and some water. Whew, you got a breakfast of champions. Rock and roll. Come on, Liz.
Tell me.
This is camping trip number 42. Well, what you do is you get a dose. Get a dough, and you get a stick, and you wrap the dough around the stick, and then you cook it, and then you got yourself a big old nice bread roll, nice and warm.
You cook it over the fire?
Yeah, and you definitely cook it over the fire.
Cool.
That's it.
Okay.
sleeping tip number 45, always have cell coverage.
Camp tip of the day, besides the great job that little kid did a while ago, keep an extra strap, tree strap with you, that way you don't have to put a nail on a tree and you can tie and hold your pack up where you're working. Just one utility strap works just fine. And that's the camp tip of the day, brought to you by Bass Pro Shop. Leave the audio on when we go over this bridge, you're going to hear some trout say, there goes the slate. Well, as we're walking out, we noticed several places that we sort of walked down to fish, and this is one of them. But below the bridge, they were hitting like crazy yesterday. Can't complain too much, but it was a sweet spot.
Through hikers.
We got a Richmond, Virginia, a Carole James, Matthias Kosegi from Baldwinsville, New York, from Gutterschlau, St. Louis, Missouri, to Gutterschlau, care of Mountain Mama. Well, boys, we finally made it to Mountain Mama's. Get this big, delicious hamburger. Look at that.
That's a good looking burger.
Wee. Look at that. Look at the meat on that. Get you some. Oh,
we got some fries.
Phew.
Boy, I've been waiting on this. I'm starving.
How's the fries?
Excellent.
Tell you what, I never thought I'd miss ketchup so much. It's some good stuff. And that is one of the biggest burgers I think I've seen in a long time.
Awesome.
Say something, Tim. I'm too busy eating.
Good stuff.
You didn't get it on.
Hey, get the cards out. Yeah. Call that in just a second. Nick, I sure do apologize for groping you last night in this hotel room, but I enjoyed it.
Where's my phone at?
For all you Sunday school kids, when I take a weekend off from Sunday school, you make a comment, well, you didn't go to church, you took a weekend off, you're about to see that we do church even when we're on the road. So wear that.
Psalm 95. Sing joyful songs to the Lord. Praise the mighty rock where we are safe. Come to worship him with thankful hearts and songs of praise.
Because of the GPS points we took along the way, we were able to retrace our steps on the map. We followed Gunter Fork up to this point where we left the trail. We proceeded up the creek, eventually reaching the end of the creek where we stopped in 2004. Then we went up and over the ridge through rhododendron and thorns, stopping briefly in a briar patch at the top. We pushed and slipped through the thorns and rhododendron until we reached another creek. We then followed this creek up to the crash site. At this point, it was so late in the day, we had a little time left to search for the plane. So, abandoning the search, we followed the creek all the way out to the trail, avoiding the ridge with rhododendron and thorns. Now we know that in 2006, we can pretty easily follow the creek all the way up to the crash site, finding the plane.
If you got the camera in here.
I'm about to cuss when I run down my digits. I want you to love. Look, you ain't got to have a start.
Oh, baby. He's got
Bible tip. Tip of the day, when your hands are frostbitten and you think they're going to fall off, fall from oatmeal and squeeze it. Survival tip of the day brought to you by Cabela's.
I have found a replacement for silicone breast implants.
58 for oatmeal.
Bear country?
No.
You haven't?
Yeah.
Chuckleheads.
What? Oh, you're not supposed to have candy.
Not supposed to have candy. Disgusting. That's a good one.
Listen up, guys.
What's the first rule of a campsite in bear country?
Don't put your food.
In your tent, that's a good one.
Don't take them off.
That's true.
Don't run when you see one.
Don't run when you see one, that's another good one.
Put your food up kind of high up the tree.
That's right. Can you keep a camera film in your tent?
Yeah.
What about chewing gum?
I don't know.
What should you take in your tent with you?
Sleeping bag,
and something.
Pumpkin
knife. And
that's it, isn't it? Don't take your food.
You've been cooking fish in a skillet with oil. Before you get in your tent, what should you do after you packed everything up?
Wash it.
You think it's a good idea to change your clothes?
Yeah.
Good point. I'll tell you a little story I heard that's a local story around here. Last year I was fishing Hazel Creek on the other side of the park, and there was a teacher from Tennessee Tech over in Cookeville, Tennessee, who was an outdoor skills teacher. And she was actually camping on this side of the park. I don't know if it was at this site or one of the sites around this area.
And she did everything right. She doesn't, I mean, she plays by the rules as far as what to do in bear country. One night she was laying in her tent. She was in a two-man tent with one of her students. And she was asleep. And she heard what she thought was somebody unzipping her tent. And she kind of froze up in fear, locked up, which is probably what I would have done. And just kind of laid there motionless. And all of a sudden she felt something stick, just put its hand on top of her head and roll it around. Roll it around a little bit and then it stopped. And she heard whatever it was kind of move away from the tent. So when she got up enough nerve, she jumped up, unzipped her tent, stuck her head out with her headlamp, and saw a mother bear and her cub walking off. The sound she heard wasn't the zipper on the tent. It was the bear's claws going down through the sidewall of the tent. So it ripped the tent open, and it was feeling for food. And when it felt her head and rolled her head around a little bit, realized either that somebody was in there or it wasn't food, and then walked off. Probably the most dangerous bear there is a mother with a cub. So don't ever get between a mama and her cub. It will certainly, it certainly could be dangerous. Thankfully, there's only been one person killed in this park by a bear, and that was, I think, 3 years ago. And that was a lady who was with her ex-husband.
I thought that they got killed and left the remains of the bear.
That was a rumor going around, and they had to investigate it that way. But they proved that the bears are what killed her. And they believe what happened is, by the way the scene looked, is that she ran. She started running from a bear, and as somebody mentioned a minute ago, you don't. What do you do when you're countered by a bear?
You talk to him and just back up slowly.
Back up slowly, and you never turn your back on them, do you? Always keep your face, always face the bear, but never make eye contact with the bear. Always keep, just look off to the side of it. Let them know your face is toward them. Always let a bear know you're there, too. Don't, if you've got plenty of distance where you can back away without him knowing, that's fine, but if you're within their a zone that would make them uncomfortable, you need to let them know you're there.
Mm-hmm.
the Lord for what he's gonna do in us from the heavens above. I thank the Lord for the smile he's put on my face. I thank the Lord for his grace. I thank the Lord for the joy that he has given to me. Now I know that I am really set free. Everybody, everybody, everybody praise the Lord.
Power, I will go till all the nations know.